Hello everyone, today we are going to start with chapter number 3, indices and cube root. So before starting with that chapter, let's revise the laws of indices. So these are the laws of indices that are being given in the textbook, which we had done last year also. So today is going to be just the revision. We are going to refresh all the laws of indices. Okay, so when such a number is been given, we call the 2 as the base and 5 as the index. Okay, so we all are familiar with base and index. So why 2 as to 5? Because 2 is written 5 times. Got it, children? This is what we have done last to last year also. What about the laws of indices? So these are the laws of indices. That means a raised to m into a raised to n is equal to a m plus n. So you all have to only remember when there is multiplication, you all have to add. When there is division, you all have to subtract. When there is multiplication, but it is inserted with a bracket. Okay, so when there is a bracket, you all have to separately multiply m. Got it, children? Okay, so this multiplication is different and this multiplication is different, children. Okay, both are not same. Over here we have to add, whereas over here we have to multiply m to a and b both. Okay, then a, when the index is 0, its value is 1. You all have to remember this. Okay, then a minus m is supposed to be a upon a raised to m. Got it? A m complete bracket, that means we have to multiply m and n with a. Got it, children? So a will remain as it is, remove the bracket, multiply these, where sign has not been given, but we have to multiply them. Okay, same for the division. This is supposed to be the division, children. Okay, it looks like a fraction, but it is a division. So a is to be multiplied with a raised to m and b raised to n. Got it? Same is for minus m. Okay, now for minus m, here you all have to be little careful. When there is minus sign, over here plus sign was there. That is why a came in the same place as numerator and denominator. Okay, but over here when minus sign is there, b will go above. We have to reciprocate. Okay, we have learned this last year also. This is called as reciprocation. Reciprocate b above and a will come over here, and minus m will change to plus m. So why we have done all this reciprocate indices? Because we have to remove the minus sign. Okay, we have to get a positive sign. So I hope all these laws are revised very well. Now let's start with the exercise. Children, if you all want me to solve this part from the textbook, please mention in the comment section. I will solve it, or it's very easy. You all have to just follow these rules and then fill in the boxes that have been empty over here. Okay, but it's very easy. And if you all are not able to understand it, or you all are not able to do it, please mention in the comment section. I will do it for you all. Okay, a separate video will be made for this. Now let's start with practice set number 3.1. Question number 1, express the following number in index form. Okay, now index form means you all have words have been given, you all have to write it in the form of numbers. Okay, it's that easy. Fifth root of 13. Okay, fifth root of 13 means 13 is going to come over here. Okay, we all have to write it little bigger. And fifth root of 13 means 1 upon 5. Got it, children? So it is very easy to write it. Don't make mistake over here. Write this bigger number and this root that you all have to write, write it little smaller. Okay, now sixth root of 9. So 9 will come over here. 1 upon 6. Square root of 256. Now how are you going to write square root of 256? So again, 256 will come as the base. Okay, and for the index, you all have to write 1 upon 2. Now, we all know square means 2. Cube means 3. The value has to be 3. Okay, children, I hope it is clear to everyone. If there is given square, you all have to take the value as 2. When there is been given cube, you all have to take the value as 3. Next question is same. cube root of 17. That means 17 will come over here, 1 upon 3. Now many of you all are going to think, what does cube and square means? So for those students, I have written it over here. Go through this. Okay. Now 8th root of 100. So 100 will come over here. And 8th root means 1 upon 8. 7th root of 30. So 30 will come over here. And 1 upon 7. Isn't it easy? Now, next question is, write in the form of nth root of a in each of the following numbers. That means, now numbers have been given to you all, index form has been given to you all, you all have to write in the form of words as just ulta of first question. Okay, so now it has been given 81 raised to 1 upon 4. So, 4th root, isn't it? 4th root of 81. Alright, now over here 2 is there. So what I said for 2, you all have to use square. So square root of 49. You all have to learn to write it in words also, children, as you all have understood to write it in the form of index. Okay, now over here 5th root of 15. Then 9th root of 512. Okay. Then 19th, isn't it? Root of 100. And 7th root of 6. Isn't it easy? Now, first exercise has been done from this chapter. Let's move on to the second exercise. Okay, practice set number 3.2. Now, over here, there is a table that has been given. I'll show you in the textbook itself. So, this is the exercise that we are going to solve. So, you all can solve it in the form of table. Or you all can solve it in the form of open as I am doing it. Okay, any which you all can form. Or you all can just solve and then you all can write it in the form of table. Okay, any one can be done. Not both of them. Okay, now in this question, complete the following table. Number is being given to you all. You all have to find the power of the root and square root of the cube of the, root of the power. Okay, I'll show you. So this is the number, you all have to write power of the root and root of the power means ulta. Okay, root of the power and power of the root. Now I'll show you how to write it. Okay, so first we will write power of the root of this number. So it is going to be cube. 3 means cube. Cube of square, isn't it? Both 3 and 2 is there. Okay, so cube of square root of 225. Okay, and next, that is root of the power is going to be square root of cube of 225. Okay, so first what you all have to do, cube means 3 of square root of 225. Understand it. Ulta you all have to do in the next one. That is root of the power. Root of the power. Okay. So square root of cube of 225. Just ulta you all have to write. Now next we will do that so that it will be more clear. The first one was being done in the textbook also. Okay. So 45 and 4 upon 5 has been given. So first we will write 4th. That is power of the root. Power of the root is 4th power of 5th root. Isn't it? First 4 upon 5 is there. Isn't it 4 upon 5? So therefore 4th power of 5th root of 45. Children, you all have to understand and write it down. Don't get confused. It's very easy. Now ulta you all have to do. That is 5th or you all can write the number also. Fifth root of fourth power of 45. Now you will see just ulta sentence I have written for the root of the power. Next is 81, 6 upon 7, so it is going to be 6th power of 7th, or you all can write it in words also, 7th root of 81, or now you all have to write the root of the power, that is 7th, you all can write this also, okay, so 7th root of 6th power of 81. Okay children, so I have written both ways, in words also and in number also. Okay, so you all can write number also both and words also both, no problem. Now 100, 4 raised to 10, so 4th power of the 10th root of 100. Now let's write the root of the power, that is 10th root of 4th. I will write it in words only children. 4th power of 100. So instead of spelling, you all can write this also, not both, okay, any one of this. Now the fifth one is 21, 3 raised to 7, that is 3rd power of 7th root of 21, power of root of the power 7th root of 3rd power of 21. Got it children, isn't it easy? So you all can fill in the form of table also. In table I don't think so this will get fixed, so you all can write it in this form also as I have written. Okay, now let's move on to the second question from this practice set. Now what you all have to do is write the following numbers in the form of rational indices. Okay, rational indices means you all sentence has been given, you all have to just write one word for this sentence. Okay, one alphabet or a number you all have to write it for this sentence. So the first is square root of 5th power of 121. Now this you all have to write in this form. We have written it in this form, isn't it? The power of the root and root of the power. In the same way, these are the questions that have been given. You all have to just form the number. So square root of 5th power of 121 means 121 obviously will come over here. Square root. Okay, square root means 2 will come over here of 5th power. So 5th power. Okay, so you all have to understand square root will come over here, power will come over here. It is that easy. Okay, now 324. 324 cube of 4th root of, you all have to understand, cube of 4th root. Cube of 4th root means 4 will come over here and cube will come over here. Got it children? Understand it. Cube of 4th root. So 4th root means, you will understand that root means everywhere root has to come at the second place. Okay, and cube means 3 obviously. Now 5th root of square of 264. Okay, so 264 we will write over here, 5th root. Okay, again as I said, 5th root means it will come over here and square. So square means 2 will come over here. This is very tricky. Understand it. Root has to come in the second place and square, cube, power of 5th will come over here in the first place. Okay, upon. Now cube of cube root of 3. Okay, so don't get confused. 3 will come over here. Cube root means 3 will come over here and cube means it will come over here. Got it? I hope this exercise I have made it very clear to, for you all to understand. Still, if you all have any queries, please let me know in the comment section children. I would love to hear from you all. See you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye.